When you think of WA, trout fishing isn't the first thing that springs to mind. But Nick will tell you that if you take the time, there are some great places to find them in the southwest. One of his favourites is Waroona Dam. You can easily get a small boat in here and, as it turns out, about 250 larger ones with engines from a V8 supercar as well, as you'll see. It was far from tranquil, and I was sure this would mean there'd be no fish, but as we're about to find out, these fish seem to actually like it.
Well, here we are, Waroona Dam, and it's changed a little bit since I've been down here. It's been quite a few years. Oh, it's a little rainbow trout, actually. It's a little yearling. Now, first fish finally come along, and guess what lure it's on? It's on the old faithful Rapala. And have a look at this. This is what we've had to put up with. They're having fun, we're having fun.
Rainbow trout were introduced to WA in 1927 and are native to Pacific rivers of North America and Asia. They won't breed unless they have a gravelly riverbed, and this is bad news for WA because these are much rarer here than in other places. So a dedicated army of people, many of whom are volunteers, keep stocking WA waterways with these fish just so we can catch them. Aren't we lucky?
Here we go, our first little rainbow trout for the day, or for the trip. We can land him. Beautiful. There we go. A little yearling rainbow trout. Now this fish was probably released into this dam recently, probably last year or the year before, as a fingerling fish. Now this fish has grown up to be a yearling fish now. So we'll just pop this hook out, get him back in the water where he belongs. It's a beautiful little yearling rainbow trout, and I was mistaken.
Hang on, you got a fish on there too.
Okay, and the other rod's gone off. That last fish was actually on a little SX40, a little red lure that I'd put out. Let's give you a look at that one. See, let's back up, Steve. It's that little pattern there, little SX40. So. Very unusual, because normally all my fish, and I mean all my fish, come on this lure. It's my favourite lure. It's a Rapala CD5 in the natural rainbow trout pattern. And it's caught more trout and redfin for me than all my other lures put together in the box. I dare say this will be another little yearling rainbow trout, because they're swimming around together in a school. Yep. And as you can see, they're beautiful little fish. Try to get a bit of footage of him in the water there. They're really beautiful little fish, look at that. And he looks exactly like the lure he just ate. So there we go. He's just under 30 centimetres. They have to be 30 centimetres to be legal, so we weren't going to keep this one anyway, so just keep him on station and off he goes. So, plenty of rainbow trout around, regardless of all the noise. Trail bike riders, jet skis, ski boats, and we're just quietly moving around here with the electric motor, catching a few fish in between them. Just running a little experiment here now. We've done one half of the dam with the electric motor. I said to Steve, why don't we just put the petrol motor on? We'll see if that makes any difference. So we're just, we've moved about 3 metres and the rod's gone off with that little bit of an increased speed. So I was trolling at 3 to 3.5 knots. Put the petrol motor on, picked up the boat speed to 4, 4.5 knots, and whack, straight away, we've had a hit. So like I said before, just that little bit of an increase in speed generally gets these freshwater fish fired up. This one's a little rainbow trout again. A little tiny, little yearling. And he's on the Rapala this time. It's my favourite lure. And you can see how similar this fish is to the colour of this lure. It's almost identical. So, the old rainbow trout pattern Rapala. catching the old rainbow trout out in the wild. Off he goes. Get this one back in the water, and we'll see. We end up with 4 fish on the electric motor. Now we'll see how many we get with the petrol. Let's reverse back on this one, Steve. This feels like it's got a lot of weight to it. And guess where we are, mate? You have a look down in the water down here. See the waterfall below us? It's the old Waroona waterfall. I'd say this could be a redfin or a nice big broodstock trout. It's got a bit of weight to it and it's staying nice and deep. Redfin would have planed up by now, so there it is, a nice trout. All right, beautiful. This is the one we've been after. Broodstock rainbow trout. They're released into this dam every year in rather large numbers. And this is my favourite spot to catch them, right at the base of this waterfall here. It's a male. A little male broodstock trout. It's not going to be done yet. You notice the pointed nose, the hooked jaw? That's how I know it's a male. It's a good fish. And what I really need to do is get this other rod in, because it's got a sinking lure on it. If I don't get it in, it's going to get stuck on the bottom. So I'm going to have to hold this fish here for a little bit, wind my other lure in, and then net this fish myself. Because Steve's got his hands full with the camera there. The fish is behaving himself nicely, Bella, isn't he? Yes, he is. He's hooked rather well. Here comes our other lure. We'll just wind that right up to the rod tip. Get that right out of the way. Grab our net. Should have ourselves a fish. There we go. One beautiful little broodstock rainbow trout. Let's back us out of here. And if you have a look at the colour of his back, exactly the same colour as that Rapala lure that I was using. You see the hook jaw on the male? Oh, there he goes. Little hook jaw on that male. That's how you can tell. These females have a much smaller, much slender, prettier head. And a rounder body. That fish was quite thin, quite long, so it's a good start anyway. We're going to see if there's any bigger females around for us. Yeah, I like to troll around 3.5 knots, which is fairly quick for trout. Most people troll around 2.5 to 2.8 knots. I like 3, 3.5. Bit of speed. Tends to entice them into striking. If they get too long a look at the lure, they've got very good eyesight, trout, so I like something to flash past them pretty quick. It resembles a small trout. I'll hit it every time. Whoa, whatever this is, nearly dragged the rod out of my hand, so should be a quick fish. Oh yeah, nice rainbow trout out there, see him? And now, the reason I'm keeping my rod tip low is to try and avoid the fish from jumping and throwing the hook. Just change the hooks on this lure, because I didn't like the style of the hook that I had on there. It was it was like an eagle claw shape. It was very wide gaped. So I've changed it over. And now this fish is doing its best to try and throw it again, like that last fish did. It's just gone through a tree, out the other side. Try and angle him back this way. Watch out, Bella. 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 Got a dog in my net. Get out of the net. Yes. Beauty. And there she is. Our first female broodstock rainbow trout. All right, what do you think of that one, Bella? That's a much better. Beautiful female rainbow trout. See the slender head? See the spots right down on the top of the nose, like I said before? Brown trout? No. You're coming home with me. That's 2 fish that I wanted to take home that I nearly lost. That was a quick grab. So, I will put my fingers in the fish's gills. I don't normally. I will now, so I don't let this fish go again. But there you go. Beautiful rainbow trout. See the beautiful markings down the side of the fish here? Beautiful spots on the top. And see how similar the coloration in this fish is to this lure. Watch out, fella. See the goldness in the back of this lure? See that in the light? Look at that. It's exactly the same, isn't it? And that's why these fish like eating little rainbow trout pattern rapalas. So there's one. It's only very small. Not quite 44 centimetres. So we're used to catching them up around 50 plus down at Harvey Dam. This is a nice trout down here in Waroona Dam. Take that fish home. Beautiful in the smoker or in the pan or in the oven. Ah yes, the serenity of Waroona Dam. Trail bikes, jet skis and ski boats. But apart from that, beautiful bush, beautiful scenery, and there are quite a few rainbow trout getting around at the moment. So we've been targeting them on hard body lures. The first lure I've picked here is a very natural coloured rainbow trout pattern rapala. It's actually my favourite hard body lure I've got in this entire selection, and it's probably caught more rainbow trout than all those lures in my box put together. Just goes to show you how good the old CD5 rapalas are. So, another good lure. The old Celta. The spinning blade on this lure creates a lot of vibration through the water. It's very, very noisy and very attractive to most freshwater fish species. So, another good option, the old Celta, as well as the hard-bodied rapala. But what I'll also do is, I'll use all these natural colours here, these reds. A lot of redfin perch and things like that around this area, so I'll use these little red coloured lures as well in this nice bright sunlight. With a bit of luck, we should be able to come up with a few little rainbow trout out here in Waroona Dam. Well, that certainly hit like a sledgehammer. It's got a bit of weight to it, this fish. Oh, it's a jumper. Oh, it's a little yearling. You know what, it'll be foul hooked. That's why it's like pulling a billy lid in. Just turn this boat around. Well, the little SX40, a red one. Such a bright sunny day, so I thought, red. It'll turn on the red fin and encourage these rainbows into striking, and it sure has. Oh, a little jumper. He's hooked just under the chin there, you can see. So I'm pulling him up like a bit of a bibless minnow. He's got both hooks in him. Should be able to just lift him. Now, beautiful little rainbow trout. Get some pliers out. Oh, there we go. Just trying to release this. Get those hooks out nice and easy. Get my hands nice and wet so you can handle these fish. And I'll be off. All right, another little rainbow trout. Now, we've got very calm, very clear conditions out here today, so I do not want these fish to see our leaders. So a very, very thin fluorocarbon leader. We'll start off with 6 pound. That way it won't inhibit the action of the lure and the fish won't be able to see it. So fluorocarbon, 6 pound leader, and a nice little clip. Just to clip our lures on and off with. That way we don't have to cut down on the size of our leader throughout the day. I'll start off with a zero size here, and I might even have to go down to double zero. Trout have very good eyesight, so. Little clips, they're very strong. Fluorocarbon leaders, little 1000 class Shimano spin outfit. Doesn't have to be too expensive. This outfit probably retails for around about $200 to $300. What a lot of fun. We'll go and jump in the boat, check out Waroona Dam. Yeah, well, we just had an absolute monster strike out here on the point before. Coming up to the perfect time of the day. It's around about 4:30 in the afternoon, low light period. And the fish are starting to come on. Gone back to the electric motor, so we're nice and quiet. Just trying to work this fish inside this other line. With a bit of luck. Oh yeah, feels all right. Might be, Those little sharp head shakes sometimes give it away to being a little yearling trout, but you never know. It's coming in quite deep. Oh yeah, no, it's not a bad one. You beauty. Little jumper. It looks like a little male, actually. It's got quite a grub down tail. Yep, looks like a little male, I'd say. Very, very similar to the other fish that we caught down here on the waterfall, which is where we're just about to come up to. Now these male trout, as you noticed, are a little bit more energetic than the female, so they jump around a bit. He's not ready for the net, so I'll get him across the surface. There we go. Straight away you can notice the longer jaw of the male. Much longer jaw. And look at that, he's eating the old Rapala. Crane Bay trout pattern once again. And there we go. Beautiful little male rainbow trout taken down here in Waroona. See the long jaw down here. And the other thing of interest, very worn down tail. These fish swim around in the tanks together in their hundreds, and then they're released into here. So a worn down one, as opposed to the beautiful female fish that we caught before. Need to go back and swim off with these girls. Whoa, well. Here's our first female. Oh no, it's a rainbow. You know how to tell the difference between brown trout and rainbow trout? The only true difference is rainbow trout have spots on the head. That's why I can tell straight away that is a female rainbow and not a brown. Anyway, I'm just gonna put this in the net before it swims off. But,
look at it in the net.
Could see that treble working its way loose, so I thought I'd grab the net. Instead of talking, put that fish in the boat, because it was a nice female rainbow to take home. But anyway, back to the drawing board, go and get some more. Oh, he just missed it again. Just slow it down a tiny little bit. There's a very fine line between too quick and not quick enough. If you can find that perfect little speed in the middle, you won't pull hooks, you get plenty of strikes, you catch plenty of fish. That's what we've been doing today. 3.7, Steve, seems to be the ideal speed. Started off with a nice start here this morning. Got ourselves a 32 centimetre rainbow straight away. And now we've just trolled around at another 30 feet. And this fish has got a bit of weight to it. So hoping it's a decent redfin or a decent trout. It's coming in nice and deep, nice and slow, and it's got a bit of weight to it. So nice rainbow. Beautiful. There we go. Another beautiful female rainbow trout taken down here in Waroona Dam. Taken on the SX40 Eco Gear natural rainbow trout pattern. Beautiful little lure, nice strong hooks. Whoa, what a hot little fish. Just ripped line off in the rod holder, did about 3 cartwheels. Putting up a real good little count for himself, this little rainbow. Look at that. Hey, he's a real good little jumper. It's funny, Steve and I were just talking about the two different strikes that I like to go for. And what we're doing at the moment, we're fishing with fairly small, natural pattern lures. And what that's going to do is induce a bite strike. So these fish are actually, the bigger fish are biting these lures because they think they're a smaller prey item. And these smaller fish are attacking these lures out of aggression. So these lures are too big for these smaller fish to eat, but they're still coming up and having a go at them because they think that it's another trout coming into their area. So, two different types of strikes. A bite strike, when the fish wants to bite and eat and swallow. And the other one, an aggression strike. The size of that lure, the size of that fish. He's come over and had a crack at that lure, thinking it was another little trout swimming through his area. Had quite a crack at it, didn't he? Right, mate, we'll get you back in the water where you belong.
Watch your step or I'll knock you down. If I do, I won't turn round. I'll just leave you with the pieces. When I'm around, you're never safe. Looking for some other place. Well, I never said life was easy. Just what you want. We're doing it my way. Hey, hey, hey. You speak my name, you shake your fist, wishing that I wasn't here, or rather that I didn't know you. Close your curtains, lower your blinds. That just tells me you're inside. You're so scared I almost know you. Doing it my way. Hey, hey, hey. Well, now I'm feeling fine, I'm feeling highway. Say what I like what I say, yeah. And you can say just what you want. We're doing it my way. Hey!